The drug that had a stranglehold on the city, its neighborhoods, and many of its people. Since that time, police have raided more drug dens, confiscated more guns and money, arrested more dealers than ever before. Now
Ed, they call crack freebasing. It's not like what Richard Pryor used to do, purifying cocaine with volatile chemicals. Crack is smoking a less volatile, ready-made product that is far from pure. But crack is only a symptom of a much larger problem, the new age of drugs. Drugs that all have one thing in common. They're more frightening than anything we've ever seen.
It is so intense. I can't even describe it. It's the best. It really is.
Okay, to begin, it's Robert, how do you spell your last name?
S-T-U-T-M-A-N.
And your title?
Special Agent in Charge of the Drug Enforcement Administration for New York.
Hearing a lot about crack, and all these reports, are they overblown? Are they exaggerated? Is this as much of a problem as we're being led to believe?
It's an interesting question. I got transferred here 6 months ago, and one of the first briefings I got from my staff in New York was on crack. And my original conception, I remember it very clearly, was this is a fad that may be being overblown. I have completely turned around in the past 6 months. I think it has is very close to becoming the drug of choice in New York, but I think more importantly, because of the reasons it has become the drug of choice in New York, I think we are in a position of in the near future, it is going to become one of the drugs of choice in the United States.
Good evening. A day of surveillance by the Leon County Sheriff's Department paid off with a crack cocaine bust tonight. The raid at Bennett's grocery store on Georgia Street yielded about 2 ounces of large crack cocaine granules and $2,000 in cash. Arrested is 29-year-old William Matthews of Harlem Street. He's known on the street as Baby Boy. Investigators say the drug was sold openly to all comers.
It was my girl.
These recovering addicts say they ended up spending more on cheap rock cocaine than pure cocaine because smoking the drug is so addictive they didn't know when to stop. Yes. Unlike other drugs they've used over the years, crack destroyed their lives in a matter of months. It makes rich people poor and poor people desperate. This man pawned his sister's car for some rock. His mother was his next victim.
She had just told me, look, I got these $300 or so for my eyes. I got to go get an operation tomorrow. I went home and took that money and went back and used again $200.
This is where they come back to, the base houses.
Base houses. I've seen girls come in there, sell their bodies, and do things that are incredible. I mean, things you couldn't even pay a hooker to do. But these girls, once they got on it, the guys in the house knew they could do whatever they wanted.
Police.
All right, once again, are these reports overblown?
When I first got here 6 months ago, I got a briefing on crack. My original estimate was this may be a fad that is being overblown. Since then, I have completely changed my mind. It is a drug that has almost taken over New York as the drug of choice, and I think the reasons that it has taken over New York are valid in the rest of the country. My personal estimate is we will, in the near future, see crack becoming one of the drugs of choice in the United States.
How long have you been an agent, and is anything compared to what you've seen?
I've been a federal drug agent for 21 years, and I have never seen a drug phenomenon like this anywhere.
What do you mean?
I have never seen a drug so quickly become popular in across-the-board socioeconomic groups. This is a drug that started in the ghettos of Harlem, is now widely accepted in the poorest as well as the richest communities. We see kids from the most wealthy suburbs using it. We see kids from the poorest ghetto using it. We jokingly in our office say it's a drug that started on 145th Street and went to 42nd Street in 3 months. And 3 months after that, it went from 42nd Street to the entire Northeast.
Do we have any idea?
Jane, what could be done to stop the spread of those new drugs?
Well, Senator Lawton Childs is trying to toughen up laws on these kinds of drugs, but everyone says law enforcement isn't the only answer. You have to make it socially unacceptable to use these drugs. And if people start dying from them, that might help. Cocaine deaths in Dade County have now jumped to about 2 a week.
And we just learned that basketball star Lynn Bias may have died from smoking cocaine. So I guess those addicts were very lucky.
They are, and I want to thank the people at Concept House in Village South, where those addicts are recovering, for all the help they gave us in this story.
Thank you for that story, Jane.
That's right. Say no to crack so you can live.
Be a winner. Stay off crack. For more information, call the state's toll-free number, 1-800-522-5353.
If you were a client and you came to my house and you started smoking, and for example, you had $500, I would make sure you wouldn't leave with a penny. And it wouldn't be hard to do it. just that one hit, and I'll take every penny you got.
How do you live with yourself?
I cry all the way to the bank. Let's just say that.
There was another warning about cocaine today.
Crack now has spread to almost every American city.
It is a problem in Houston, Philadelphia, Kansas City, Tucson, and Sacramento.
In the 1980s, the media sounded the alarm that a new drug, crack cocaine, was taking over American cities and that it had an especially devastating effect on pregnant women and their newborns.
A new study says that babies born to women who use cocaine during pregnancy are three times as likely to be born with birth defects.
They tend to be what we call jittery.
They're very, very high risk for cerebral palsy, mental retardation.
They are prone to hypertension, strokes, and sudden infant death syndrome.
These children, who are the most expensive babies ever born in America, are going to overwhelm every social service delivery system that they come in contact with throughout the rest of their lives.
Many of you may be thinking, well, drugs don't concern me, but it does concern you. It concerns us all because of the way it tears at our lives and because it's aimed at destroying the brightness and life of the sons and daughters of the United States. For 5 years, I've been traveling across the country, learning and listening, and one of the most hopeful signs I've seen is the building of an essential new awareness of how terrible and threatening drug abuse is to our society.
In 1982, to fight the smugglers here, the Reagan administration created the South Florida Task Force. But local officials say the federal effort is more talk than action. It is not stopping the flow of drugs. Art Nierbas of the Metro Dade Police.
There is more cocaine available today than almost any time in our history.
We get a lot of tough talking about a war on drugs and the effort that's going to be put into it, and then on the other hand, we find that press release is not backed up by commitment.
And in a time of drastic budget cuts, there is nowhere near enough money to pay for the fight against drugs. The police are completely outnumbered.
On the Miami River, we get in approximately 5 or 6 ships per day, and if we check 2, that's a lot.
Police say they don't really know what percentage of the cocaine traffic they are stopping, but it's not much.
Last year, we seized about 50,000 pounds of cocaine here in Florida, which is double what we seized the previous year.
Record seizures every year. But the drug business is so profitable, and there is so little risk, that cocaine keeps getting cheaper and more pure.
He tried to testify 3 times. You guys haven't called him yet. Why? He has valuable information. He's a country guy. They're not going to tell you.
We are proceeding.
to investigate George Bush. And here's the evidence in this special report if anybody cares to find out what the truth is.
We understand the high level of emotional involvement, and we are prepared to allow some leeway to have you express yourselves, although this is not in accordance with the regular rules. We are prepared to listen to you. This meeting, Senator, the San Jose Mercury News identified a number of individuals as being involved in the drug trade and of having possible connections with the CIA, and we have proceeded to try to determine what the evidence is and what the facts are.
Convening this hearing and also making a public hearing.
West Los Angeles, on the allegation of use of funds to support the Contras.
I would say that that all of this story, rather than about crack, is about crap. That's my
crap.
Yes. Rather than crack, is crap. That's the way I look at it. It's a preposterous,
unfounded,
ridiculous.